would want to switch on to our next session. Basically, it's about best practices in alumni relations, and we have very distinguished guest who has been doing a lot of activities at their individual college level. I will take a couple of minutes to introduce each of you. We have Professor Meenakshi Vishwanathan. She is head of alumni affairs and CSR at IIIT Hyderabad. She has completed master's from IIT Roorkee and her second master's from Wayne State University. And a long career in IT, in bioinformatics, she actually joined IIIT to set up the entire alumni office there. So welcome to the panel, ma'am. Ma'am, you are mute. Maybe you have to unmute each of you. Yeah.
Thank you, Paresh. Thank Happy you, to be here. Good morning, everybody.
And next we have Dr. Sumi Jha. She is Honorable Secretary at NITI Alumni Association. That's my alma mater, actually. And she's also professor at OB and HR at NITI. She also did her doctorates from NITI and has been instrumental at NITI's growth. Like, as we've seen that she's been working for almost 5 years plus in NITI alumni office, actually more than that, I think, ma'am. And being in, being a part of NITI as a student and then also taking up the office, she brings a very distinct privilege here. She's also been awarded the best management faculty by AIIMS International in 2019. Welcome to the panel, ma'am.
Thank you.
We have Mr. Pradeep Singla.
Welcome, everyone.
We have Mr. Pradeep Singla. He's a manager of alumni relations at UPS Dehradun. He has done his MBA from Postuma Business School and has a deep knowledge in higher education domain specifically. And Pradeep brings in has been very instrumental in setting up very distinct initiatives at UPS. UPS has been at forefront of alumni relations. He will speak about a lot of new initiatives they've been working on in the panel. So welcome to the panel, Mr. Pradeep.
Thank you, Paresh. Thanks for bringing all of us together on this call.
Sure, thank you. And Dr. Srijit is the head of corporate relations, industry interface and training and placement at JKK and institutions. He's an education guidance expert, actually, and he's been in nodal office at Skill Development. He manages the entire alumni relations for the entire group of JKK institutions, which has a mix of both engineering and the medical colleges, both applied health and this one. So pretty, he brings in a different perspective of managing alumni relations at a tier two city. It's because it's been a bit difficult for them to get people back to the college, and how is he doing that? He's going to share that with you. So let's start with the session on, I'll just stop my sharing my screen. Yeah, let's start with the session. Couple of minutes each, probably you can share what are the activities, a bit of background about the IIIT's alumni office, and what are you doing there? Meenakshi ma'am, over to you first.
Hey, good morning, everybody. IIIT is a small institute and it's a young institute. We were only 22 years old, and we have only two branches, which is ECE and computer science. So our alumni number is really small. We have about 5,000 alumni, but they are well accomplished and very cherished alumni with strong connects to the institute. So the alumni office has been actually run by the faculty for quite some time, and now we are having a proper setup office now as our numbers are increasing. So quick rundown on what we do as a day-to-day thing to keep our alumni engaged and to further our relationship with them. We have a monthly newsletter that we send out. We have an alumni feature that we feature one or two alumni every month in a blog. We write about them. We have an alumni cell in the institute, which coordinates the activities with the alumni who have passed out. So current students interacting with their alumni. We have alumni whom we invite as speakers for faculty talks, for student interactions, and specifically only with the students. And also for our convocation, we have speakers, two alumni speakers for every convocation. And whenever our faculty visit various parts of the world, our alumni will catch up with them. We do organize alumni meets every year. One annual meet at the campus, and several across the world if we have a special occasion to celebrate. And then we have alumni who've come back to join us as faculty. So we try to tap into their resources as well. So they are also our brand ambassadors as well as faculty. And then we have a very unique thing that is in IIIT is two alumni are inducted into our governing council as observers. So they actually are know how, they know exactly what's happening in the institute, and they take it back to their alumni community to share it with them. So they are also very involved in all the decision making of the current running and the future of the institute. And other than that, we have alumni, we have the oldest and the largest academic incubator. So several of our alumni have their own startups, some in conjunction with the faculty taking on the research that they have worked on. And CIE, which is our Center for Innovation and Entrepreneurship, is a very good grooming ground for our alumni for their startups. And our alumni now have gone one step further and started their own seed fund to fund, you know, IIITH alumni startups, which is, you know, a recent development and something that we're very proud of. And so we have a startup advisory. We have alumni who come back from the industry to be part of our industry advisory. We have regular roundtable conferences with the heads of the industry. Our alumni are invited to that as observers as well as participants from the industry. They also bring research connects to further know the research with the various labs that they have been involved in. So there's an engagement on all fronts with the alumni. And we recognize our alumni for every little thing that they contribute. More importantly, we want them to be helping us make the decisions. So we listen to them. So that's our one quick overview of what we do with our alumni.
Sure, ma'am. I'll come back to you with getting deep into a couple of initiatives that you've been doing. Over to you, ma'am. Sumija, before we move on to our next speaker, so there will be a chat. In the chat, we'll be our colleague will be sharing a link, which allows us to actually download and interact with all of the participants in a VR space. So it's like a game. You can actually move around and interact. So it's a bit of large file. So I just will share the link immediately so that you can keep it downloaded and installed. The instructions and all. Gagan will share that. Yeah, over to you, Sumija ma'am. So would like to hear more about initiatives at NITI.
Let me first start with NITI itself. First of all, I would like to thank my director, Mr. Professor Manoj Kumar Tiwari. He has given me this opportunity, and he had that belief that I can do this because it is a huge responsibility to connect with alumni. And secondly, I would like to start with a thank you note to Paresh himself. Rather, I should say Mr. Paresh Masade, because he is our alumnus and we are very proud of him. And he has organized this event, and he keeps on organizing such event, which is one of the way we connect to our alumni. So thank you, Paresh, for choosing me for this webinar. I just want to start with the fact that NITI Alumni Association, we operate a little differently. I was hearing the previous panel, and I just heard, I feel that we are working a little differently in a way that NITI Alumni Association is a society. We are a registered society. So therefore, a lot of autonomy is there to us. When I say registered society, we have a secretary, chairperson, president, and other members who makes executive committee body. Based on that executive committee body, that executive committee body actually decides what is to be done. The executive committee body usually comprise of the secretary, which is till now we had faculty members taking up this position. I have been secretary only since last 3 years, Paresh. Yeah. Before that, Professor Pundir was there. Yes. And he has done a very good job in connecting with alumni. Another position which is very important is treasurer's position in any society. That position also is usually given to finance faculty at NITI. So currently we have Professor Ranjini, who is a finance and accounting professor. She is taking care of that. Chairman's position, we have, it is a mutual agreement that chairman's position is with alumni of NITI. So very eminent alumni. would usually take up chairman's position, and president's position lies with the director of the NITI. So, and other members like vice chairman, MDP, vice chairman, PGP, such positions are always with alumni of NITI. So we have a good mix of alumni, faculty, and administrators in the executive body, which keeps it very balanced. It gives a very balanced approach to the executive body itself. So this is how NITI Alumni Association works. So we do have a separate office, but still I personally feel that we need to have one very dedicated officer in this office, which we do not have. Currently, primarily, we are managing with the faculty members and one staff member we have. Another important thing that I think NITI is known for is its industry connect. We have, we are a very niche kind of an institute wherein we have, we take only engineers as our students. So students who have cleared their engineering, only they can come to our institute. And we are a postgraduate institute. Second thing is, though they have completed their engineering, they can come to our institute via GATE or via CAT. So basically, we are trying to offer technical courses as well as management courses, which actually helps us in bringing industry connect a lot. Because we have our alumni in all spheres, say technical or managerial or operations. So we do not have that disconnect that, okay, fine, only technical line our alumni are, not in managerial line. So that problem we do not have. And that way, I think we are very privileged to have that niche approach that we have taken. So this is about NITI. So we have roughly... we have actually seven courses that we run. Some courses are through GATE courses and some courses are CAT courses. Apart from that, we also have Visionary Leadership Program, which is for working executives. And because it is very new course, 3 years only, rather two batches have passed this. But this Visionary Leadership course for manufacturing is also picking up, and we are trying to build our alumni base out there too. Another course which is not very general in other institutes is Fellow Program, which is equivalent to PhD. That also we offer, and we are building our alumni base in that space as well. Our alumni are located across world, and we have several initiatives. We have taken several initiatives, and we are taking several initiatives. And I think I'll discuss about all those initiatives later, Paresh.
Sure, ma'am. Quickly. Sure. Thank you, ma'am. And over to you, Pradeep, sir. Would you want to share a couple of initiatives that you've been working with specifically?
Yes, first of all, good morning to all. And I hope everybody is staying safe at this COVID time and following the government measures. And specifically, being in the education industry, I hope we are educating others for the government measures, actually. This is the time when everybody has to come together and take care of the pandemic. Coming at the this meeting, I thanks to Team Huawei to bringing all of us together. And I'm also noting down a lot of points which we can do into our committee. Currently, we are also doing a lot, but learning from everybody that is there. Coming at the UPS, it's a pretty young university. Started in 2003 with the base of 400 plus students. Currently, we have almost 13,000 plus students in the university, and with a base of 21,000 plus alumni base at this time. And if we talk about like taking something from the alumni, which is a byproduct, which happens, which we have seen the part in the last conversation also. But here I'll speak a few points which we normally believe in the giving away approach to the alumni. This is a very tough time, and we understand the industry. There are a lot of people who are losing their jobs, who are having the salary cuts, and a lot of things are there. At this point of time, what UPS is doing, UPS has announced a 5-year career guidance and placement support to the alumni. Anybody who has lost their job, they can come back to us. We will try back with our contacts, with the companies, with the experience, and we are giving them a job. Currently, if I talk about...
I think we lost you, Pratik.
The institution, there must be a lot of institutions in the market which are seeing in the current alumni parallelly, approximately 82 alumni till date we have placed in this COVID time with the new jobs. And second thing, if I come out, we understand that there will be a lot of starting after this. There are a lot of professionals will be thinking about the startups. So we have, UPS has done a collaboration with the WeWorkspace. It's kind of a self-working space, fully equipped with all the equipment. We have taken into 6 to 7 cities, and we'll be providing this space to the startups which are there with the UPS alumni. Third thing, we understand that there will be a... We understand that people are facing a lot of anxiety, depression, and job cuts and everything. So UPS has come with a special service with a tie-up with some professional company for the counseling. This counseling is available to all the alumni fraternity as well as for their families. This concept is basically alumni plus 4 family members can take the psychological counseling during this time. They can discuss about the personal matters, may it be anything. It would be fully confidential with the company. And if I move forward, that is the again a very important point. When the job cuts are happening, you understand that only the fittest people in the industry will be surviving for the longer. And I should say the comparatively better fitter people. So we have provided the subscription of the Coursera for the reskilling and upskilling to the alumni so that they can do the online courses during this lockdown and they can get the better skills and they can have more certificates in their bouquet. And they can present themselves to the industry in a better way. And one more thing that the UPS is providing a various kind of scholarships to the alumni for the higher studies also. If graduates wants to go for M.Tech, MBA and some other things, the UPS is providing a good level of scholarships to enrolling into UPS or other partner universities at the same time. That is there. So this is the I've been into like education from last 10 years initially for the enrollments and then are now into alumni. But I feel the giving away approach which UPS is using, I found it very useful actually for the alumni. Sure, this is from my side, Parish. You can take it.
And absolutely, that's a lot of things that UPS is giving away. And I remember you also quoting that the amount of money that you spend on co-working space across cities, right? So it's close to about 25 lakhs a month or something.
Absolutely, absolutely. 25,000 per station. We are almost hiring 10 stations at the same time.
Right, absolutely. So basically what it is a very unique concept that I like was entrepreneurs can actually use the space that UPS is providing at any other city, not only at the campus. So very interesting initiative that you're doing. Over to you, Dr. Srijit. So you've been specifically again on learning a large alumni base of across the different kinds of institutions, right? Right. There's a medicine, there's allied health, and there's engineering. So how do you manage that? Probably some initiatives from your side, sir. Sir, you're on mute. Your mic is on, but we are not able to hear you. No, sir, we are still not able to hear you somewhere. No, sir, your video is also off, but we are not able to hear you somewhere.
Harish, you can introduce him for some time.
Yeah. So Gagan, can you just connect with him and see on mobile? I'll just share.
Sure, sir. I'll just connect with him.
So, all right. Maybe
can you hear me now?
Yes, sir. Yes, you're back.
Cool. Yes, just a minute. I have just muted my phone.
So your video is off? Yeah.
Yes, can you see me now?
Yeah, perfectly fine. You are. Yeah,
Okay. Thank you, Varish. It is my pleasure to meet my co-panelists and participants. I am Srijit Vignesh, Head Corporate Relations, Industry Interface Training and Placements from JKK Nataraja Education Institution, from a rural region named Kumarapalayam, which is very near to Erode in Tamil Nadu. To tell about our initiatives, we feel that alumni members are actually a kind of a backbone for any growth of any institution. We feel that it is just like a human library of any institution, wherein you can see they will be sharing n number of information, they will be having n number of experiences. They could, even a normal book cannot speak more. They can deliver just a concept, but a human library can deliver it, deliver the concept with beautiful examples. They can share a n number of information for the peers. So we feel that alumni is one of the backbone. And we started working with the alumni members for various supports as mentioned by the co-panelist. We also do some kind of alumni interactions with inside our campus. We have a dental institution, pharmacy institution, engineering, arts and science, allied health sciences, all these institutions in our campus. The thing is, we try to do some collaboration between all these departments and bring out some innovative solution for the problem that persists in our region. Our region is basically a textile region, and we are trying to focus on some textile related problems initially. But we are not limited to that. We bring up, we come up with a number of solutions. To say about, we also have a co-working space. We started installing a co-working space in the name of Exponentious Springboard. And to your note, it is being headed by one of our alumni, Mr. Xavier. And he is bringing out a number of solutions based on the knowledge whatever he has gained. He started his career in a different industry. Later, knowing the things, he came back to us and he started supporting our institution being an alumni. And we are happy that our alumni members are coming back and supporting us in this region. We are not from tier 1 or tier 2 city. It is basically in the next level. So still we could make up something better with the help of the alumni support. So we feel that it is quite better.
Sure, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much for that. And also, sir, one thought that I would want you to share as we go along somewhere is basically how are you managing organization like this? Because there could be as a structure of the organization as well.
Yes. Say about the structure. I will be the first to get a felicitator for the entire alumni gang. But still, we identify some faculty members who actually employ students. Because the faculty members who are including students, they will have some good rapport with the student members. So similarly, they will pass the information to their seniors as well. So the alumni members will also be in touch with those faculty members and they will automatically get enrolled. And it is easy for us to manage with the help of deputing the faculty members who are included. Once they get in touch with those faculty members, they will come up with some ideas. They will come and meet us in person. They will contact us via phone. They will share whatever they think and they will, so that we will also try to support their ideas to a certain extent and we will try how we can make it up to the next level. So this is how we actually manage inside our institution.
Sure, sir. So I'll move on to next panelist again back. So Meenakshi ma'am, I'll just make sure that we are on speaker mode. Okay, everyone is visible. Ma'am, specifically, we have been speaking about in the last session about actually being building relationship with alumni, and I see that you have been at forefront of that. You have been very responsive to all alumni interactions and everything. So can you just share us about what are the very important things that you do that makes you very such a responsive to alumni, and why is it so important again?
First of all, we are a very small IIITH family because we have been in existence only for 22 years and with only two streams. So the number of alumni we have are small. So it's easy for us in many ways to keep the personal connect. And ever since IIIT has started, right from the first batches, they have been equally responsible for setting the direction of the institute as well as spearheading whatever establishments that need to be made in forms of clubs, in forms of curriculum, everything. The IIIT students have always been involved. In fact, they helped set up our IT system, our backend systems, our library. So it's been a culture to have them as partners more than as, you know, faculty students, that kind of relationship. And that culture has continued. And for us, so when somebody calls us or somebody, from Hyderabad and wants to meet up with somebody, it's like, just come home, you know, come on over and let's have a chat. We are always open to them. And every time they come with a request or with some suggestion, we listen to them because they are our brand ambassadors and they are the future. So in many ways, all our alumni, though young, our oldest alumni must be only 40 years old. They are in the forefront of technology, leading, you know, big companies, taking on huge responsibilities and setting the direction for the future. So we really listen to them. And what I would like to say is I'm very happy that they have included me in all their WhatsApp groups. Okay. And I do get calls anytime in the night, anytime during the day, you know, are you free for a chat? I need to connect with some alumni. We are trying to looking for an intern. Can you help me connect in a formal way, in an informal way? And we are always responding because to us, they are family. We don't think of them as, students who have passed out, and the number is small enough. And everybody remembers the faculty and the faculty remember them. So that very personal touch culture of the institute is being carried on with the alumni. And I think that's what makes it special because they remember. In fact, we have recently, we have yet to launch our first episode of our Alumni Speak series where we bring our alumni to share their experiences and talk about various things. I was very touched just last Saturday. I heard a story from a student who said she had an accident. She was a first batch ECE student. She had an accident when she was going home from the institute. And she had to have 3 major surgeries and major, skin grafts and everything. And the surgeons told her not to come back to the institute. She chose to come back to the institute to recuperate because she says, this is where I feel at home. And when one of the faculty went to see her at the hospital, she says, I'd just come out of my anesthesia. And I remember seeing this faculty's face. And she said, you're alive. Let's celebrate it. And she said, that one sentence is what I remember from the entire incident and which is what made me come back. So that is the kind of connect that the students have with the faculty and that we try to continue. And so our response is very personal. We try to put ourselves in their shoes and see what we can do for them and continue that relationship. So we are very responsive, no matter what time of the day, what time of the night, our alumni are very, special to us.
Sure, ma'am, absolutely. And I'll come back to one incident I remember with you. Before that, Sumija, ma'am, again, some specific initiatives that, which is probably unique at NITI, something special that, like few activities that you do are very unique. I want you to share those, ma'am.
Okay, Paresh, it is very difficult for me to restrict myself for few activities. So I will try to actually go in a very structured way, though I think a lot of informal inputs and informal relationship we have with our alumni, but still we have some very structured approach so that we won't miss out on anything. So what we do is we engage our alumni whole year. Okay, so we have plans almost every month, how to engage in a structured way. And apart from that, if something unstructured, informal comes, we take up. So I'll just go one by one. The first thing that we engage our alumni is during our, so when new students come in the month of June, at NITI, we have a something called induction program, wherein we induct our new students through different kind of policies, practices NITI has. And apart from that, we also induct them through NITI alumni association processes. And in that, we call our alumni to interact with students. So when they join the institute and then they see, very eminent alumni coming and talking to them, in the beginning itself, they feel, wow, I also have to go there. So that feeling we instill in the beginning of the students' entry into the college. So that is the first step we engage our alumni in the month of June. After that, we realize that, the students, the new students, they have to go for summer placement in the month of September. So usually our summer placement gets over by the end of the September month. And students are just entered into the college. They know so much and no more. So what we do is, again, in the month of August, we have a program called Tarang, which is specific for sector, to give sector specific inputs to students. So in that, what we do is we call, partner in some of the consulting organization, and they come and share with new students how this consulting world works. What kind of questions you may get, what kind of competencies you need to develop to answer the questions of recruiters who is coming from consulting background. Similarly, banking or retail. So different alumni from different sectors come and speak to new students or new joinees about the sector specific input, competencies required, how they can actually be effective in the interview that they are going to give in the month of September. So that is the second input or second interaction we have. Now, in this case, it is purely give and take. Alumni love to come and interact with the newer generation, and we receive a lot of inputs from alumni. The third is in the month of November. Every year in the month of November, we have scheduled annual alumni meet. We call it Sansmaran. This NITI alumni meet, we try to call, we also have very small alumni base because we are only, located at Mumbai. Though we are 55 years old organization, initially we had very few strength of 30 students till roughly 15 years. After that, the strength increased. So roughly we have 10,000 alumni base. And many of them comes for Sansmaran. Roughly 300 to 400 alumni join us for Sansmaran. And we try and give them a lot of goodies. Not actually to appease them or something like that, but more for our branding purpose. When I say this, I mean something like this t-shirt, which is given to alumni. We wish that alumni will wear it and go to their offices as these t-shirts as a Friday dressing. Now that helps our institute build another kind of brand, and we give very good quality products, whatever. But that is one wherein the alumni comes, and we have a lot of takeaways for alumni. We organize a conclave, CEO conclave kind of, wherein they come, share their viewpoints, students interact with them. Then we have cultural programs for alumni. So it is a whole day event on Sansmaran, which is again in the month of November. Then again from January mid to March, we have the CEO series lined up every Saturday with our alumni. So alumni would come and give their insights to our students every Saturday from the month of January mid to March. Again, in the month of April and May, we have something called Regional Alumni Meet, which is primarily for the purpose of connecting all the alumni who are located at different region. For example, it is possible that for Sansmaran, alumni from Kolkata may not come to Mumbai, but for if we are organizing a regional alumni meet, an alumni meet at Kolkata, all the alumni at Kolkata and nearby places can come and interact with. Now, this again, this regional alumni meet we usually conduct in the month of April and May, primarily because our summer students are located at different places and they can help our alumni who takes lead in regional alumni meet to engage with other alumni and help them being connected. So we basically want to be in touch with them through one or the other reason so that they feel connected and we also are in touch with them for a purpose, not just random. Apart from that, we have a lot of other initiatives that our NITI Alumni Association has started since last few years. We have scholarship, alumni give scholarship to our students and merit students. Second is faculty awards. They also instituted faculty awards, like some faculty are have done something very good in social work, so they will get that award, or some faculty has done really good research, then that they are awarded. Similarly, we also have initiatives by I would like to talk in detail about that, but I will just mention it, chair professorship. So that is another initiative which few of our alumni together has taken place, has instituted. This entrepreneurship is something which is valued a lot in our institute, and our alumni are helping us a lot in making this entrepreneurial effort a success. Our institute also has initiated something called deferred placement, wherein if one student would like to take a chance on entrepreneurship, they can actually try it while they are in the institute, and they can actually wait for 1 or 2 years. And if the entrepreneurial venture goes on well, then it is okay. Otherwise, they can come back again and join the regular placement process of NITI. So that gives them some kind of incubation period to experiment, and most of the time they do not come back. But that assurance itself is a lot for them to work on. So therefore, I feel that structured approach and timely connection with alumni are important. We are informally connected with our alumni through various WhatsApp groups. Paresh is helping us with this website, which is actually helping us in connecting with alumni, sharing a lot of information, what NITI is doing, lot of things which we are doing during COVID times get highlighted, and our alumni also responds to that really well.
Thank you, ma'am. So, yeah.
My pleasure.
Pretty good. And I would like to say that, yeah, NITI has a very good startup culture. I started the company when I was in campus. So that's...
Yeah, hostel rooms are actually incubation center for us.
So over to you, Pradeep sir, again. So specifically in... can you give some insights into the initiatives, like specifically the Coursera thing that you're giving back, and the 5-year placement support post campus? That's a huge important thing, because we were speaking about what can alumni get from the institution, and this support kind of thing is very important. Can you just throw some light about what is that initiative about and how do you actually engage?
Yes, we believe that initially, 5 years in the career of any professional is a bit struggling and bit tough. After 5 years, a person makes enough contacts to get himself placed or change a job. But first 5 years, he needs some mentoring, which kind of a job he should go, and about the profile setting. And maybe initially he has gone through a campus placement, but he sometime he's come back that is the profile is not exactly matching with my preferences and things. So we being a responsible institute, we take his request into the consideration, and we speak to his current employer that he is not fitting with this your required profile. So can we take him back from you? So after a mutual discussion, we consider his profile and we approach the another company which is into his interest area, and we make him place. And there can be certain other reasons when an alumni can come back to the college. So initially he went for the higher studies or maybe entrepreneurship, but now he wants to enter into a job. So we normally place him, and this is the actually we have like assured him that only the final placement was not the only things which was there with us. So you are lying as a responsibility or as a duty to us for coming 5 years also. The alumni who graduated in 2015, they are still in connect with us for the same. Second thing, once we speak about the Coursera thing, anytime once we go to any interview, they speak about the extra certification or extra curriculum which you have done during the college or after the college. So even if you know the skills, but if it is not certified, employer won't consider the same. So on that pattern, the Coursera we have given the access to the alumni, and many of the alumni have completed more than 10 certificates on the Coursera till date during the lockdown, as people have got a lot of time during the lockdown, so they have completed, and this will obviously increase their efficiency into the job market. And during this COVID time, what activities we are doing to involve the alumni is one of that we are doing the batch alumni meeting. It's like we in the batch of BTech computer science and for the specific specialization called cloud computing, we have batch of 114 in 2018 which has passed out. So we have called the Zoom meeting like this along with the faculty and the placement officers, and we are doing this batch wise a lot. We have target of almost doing 10 meetings every weekends, Saturday and Sunday. So this is involving a lot of alumni and understanding their concern and providing them the opportunity to grow further. And further, recently what we have done, we have a school of law as well. So from the school of law is very young. 2012 we started with the school of law. 2012 was the first batch passes out from school of law. So till date, we have almost 15 alumni who are serving as a judiciary services, as a judge into the different parts of India. So we have done a panel discussion with 11 of them last weekend. And this was giving a lot of insight about the judiciary service working during the lockdown. So this kind of few initiative we are taking to make it happen. I would like to answer one question, which is from the Q&A session of this chat webinar. Somebody asked how we can manage the updated database of alumni. So I would suggest that Vava is one of the best portals which we are using currently, and you can subscribe to the portal and keep sending your college updates, whatever happening in the college current time. Don't feel it is for the alumni. Even alumni wants to know about the college students, what is happening with the students, what you are coming up with the students things. If you will keep updating as the news and the dashboard, alumni will come back to your portal and they will keep updating the database also out there. That is from my side, Paresh. You can take it forward.
Sure, sir. Thank you very much. And again, back to you, Srijit, sir. Specifically on, you've been into corporate relations and industry interface, right? So, and a main important part is basically you've been also the training and placement officer at an organization like this. So what are the things that you do specifically for, like, because student development at an institution like yours would be much different. Can you share some thoughts and ideas about what you do there, and how do actually alumni give back in student development again?
Yes. As I mentioned before, we are in rural region. We feel it as a challenging task to get interacted with companies, to bring in companies for placements.
So your mic is off again.
I think you do is that the thing, yeah. What we do is that, sorry,
yeah, go ahead sir, nothing, go ahead, yeah.
What we do is that we just interact with the alumni members. We try to see where they got placed. We ask them what are the opportunities that they can give to the current students. And by the way, we get in touch with them frequently, at least monthly, twice or thrice. We used to get interacted with them. And this, as we started using this Bali portal, the Bali portal is giving a monthly digest on every month basis. So they will, even the alumni members gets to know about what are the things that are happening in their institution every month. So what they do is they, after seeing the messages what they receive in the monthly digest, they get in touch with us. They inquire about certain things. Even sometimes they try, they express their willingness to take part in certain activities. And to say about a dental institution, for a dentist, they will be looking for the young dentist to get work in their clinical area. So they hire them. The senior members, they hire the juniors as a dentist doctor in their own clinics. And as a pharmacy institution is concerned, you could find our people who has completed a Form D. They might be working in leading industries like Dr. Reddy's Foundation, Hindustan Drugs Private Limited. So what they do is they share the internship opportunities. The thing is that they could get the real-time exposure. The students who are currently studying, they get the real-time exposure with the help of the alumni members, interaction, what they have. So there is one more question in the Q&A panel. They ask what is the best way to keep the alumni database updated? Even after implementing the WAVI, what we find is we face little difficulties in the initial stage. And what we have decided is that to make the students to get enrolled in the WAVI portal once they are in the final semester. And we make them to get utilized to the portal so that what they feel is that they feel it little comfortable. Then after they moving out there, when we are asking them to do it, they feel it very difficult. So what we did is we spend some hours even in our regular academic hours, and we asked them to get trained on this platform. We used to make them to get interacted with some senior in the sense the alumni members. The alumni members, they will share some ideas. We will also teach them how to interact with the alumni members. Even sometimes our institution is being initiated in the year 1974, even sometimes before my birth. So we have to interact with some senior persons. They will be even in the retired stage. So we used to make the members who are studying currently to get interacted with such senior persons, and we help them to get interacted and get a relationship with them to get their career growth. So these are the things that we actually focus on in terms of corporate relations. And in addition, what I can say is that as of engineering is concerned, the alumni plays a very, very important role, because the thing is, once the student get placed, they will share the information with their immediate juniors. How the company actually works, what are the pros and cons that they face inside the company. They will share all this information to the students. So the thing is, the students will come up with the mindset that we got an information, such information from seniors. So we are not looking for such a company. We are trying for some other concern. So I am also looking for certain companies like this. So kindly bring the same company or some other companies related in this field, so that I will also get placed in certain things. All these information will be collected from the current students. So by the way, it also helps us.
I'd like to add something on what IIIT does to share some best practices. Our students are actually involved in the placement, list of companies that will come, and they are connected with all their alumni. So the alumni often come back and say, we want the top pick of our students. You're not giving us the slot to come and sit here. So we allow the students to interact with the placement officer and with the company's list. And our alumni often come back informally, even before the kids get placed. Most of them have joined their alumni startups or some other place, even before the placement start. So that's the kind of connect that they have with their alumni. And another thing that I forgot to mention was our alumni, even though it is so young and such a small number, they have an alumni fund, which has got over 1 crore rupees now. And through that fund, they support scholarships for needy students. So there are a bunch of 40 alumni who manage that fund. And when we get, we advertise to the students that, anybody in financial need can apply for the scholarship. We only send the information across to the alumni. The alumni decide based on our recommendations and based on the vote, whom they get supported. And they have a very nice way of keeping this going. They don't ask the students to return the money, but they say, if you can, in place of returning, sponsor another child once you have a job. So we are very happy to say that out of the 35 scholarships that the Alumni Fund has given out. 25 students have repaid it by sponsoring another child. And the 10 scholarships are going through. So it's a very nice culture that the alumni have set up in the institute of paying forward for the help that you get. And also, you know, they keep inducting people into their committee. We don't play a part in it other than just being, you know, the conduit for this. And the good point is for us, we give them an alumni card, which has an ID card, which gives them access to the campus through their lifetime, access to our libraries. They can book our guest houses when they come and want to visit the campus. So the connect is always there through very many structured programs, and also through this interpersonal interactions between the alumni, between the faculty and everybody else.
Sure. Thank you, ma'am. So that's a very good. So I'm actually at a fix. Basically, we are running out of time. All of our speakers have a lot of things to share. Maybe we'll have to end the meeting irrespective of things, because we are already extended more than 5 minutes and the previous session also got delayed. I would like each of you to quickly add only a couple of closing lines, two lines each about what you think, and we'll come back to that. Also, for all our audience, we have a lot of announcements at the end where we are going to help, like what are we going to do in terms of engaging the alumni communities together. And how do we bring together all of you together? So that's because there are a lot of audience who are there, attendees in the audience, who actually have a lot more insights as well. Because we know that there are a lot of institutions who are working very much. So we'll try to bring together the entire community so that we can share the best practices. Each of you probably can just give a couple of lines as an out conclusion, and then we can end the session. Maybe, ma'am. Sumija, ma'am, probably you.
As I was telling, one very good initiative that our group of alumni started was Chair Professorship Initiative, which is, it was Entrepreneurship Chair Professor, and one more initiative was Innovation Culture. In this case, what they said was students can come up with some kind of prototypes. And whatever funding which is required for prototype, alumni will pay for that. So initial seed money has been given, because anytime whenever there is a prototype generation, we have issue of funding. So that has been taken care of by our alumni, and they are doing this. For chair professorship, they want to initiate and actually strengthen our entrepreneurship. And therefore, if some highly acclaimed entrepreneur can become our chair professor, and then it will be easier for us to, easier in the sense, it will be good motivation for our students to develop more entrepreneurial characteristics. The chair professor can organize conferences and research in the area of entrepreneurship. So these are two new initiatives which we have. We have scheduled many more initiatives, like coming up with video series, coming up with webinars with alumni, and all those things we are doing. But as a closing remark, what I would like to say is, we cannot actually think of an institution without its alumni. As the previous panelist very rightly said, that if we want to get connected or remain connected with our alumni, we have to actually touch our current students. So if we are really close, or if we have touched our current students, they will remain our loyal alumni for long, because they are the best brand ambassadors any institution can have. So remain connected, remain good, remain empathetic towards our current as well as past students. Thank you.
Thank you. Pradeep, sir.
Yeah, I would love to say that you have asked a question in the last discussion, that why alumni should sign up. If an institution can get the answer for the same, what is there for the alumni in their college at this point of time of their career, then alumni will obviously stay connected. And that's the role comes of an institution to fulfill their desires and their goals and give them a direction from their best practices, how to do that. Correct. Yeah. So my point is that we should have something for the alumni. From our side, alumni will have a lot of things to support to the college in terms of guest lecture, job opportunities and fundings and a lot of things. But what an institution is doing to support that community of alumni, that is from my side.
Sure, sir. Thank you very much. And Sijit, sir.
Yeah. For any institution, I feel that caring cure in the sense cross-skilling, upskilling, reskilling and expert skilling. If all these four skilling happens, definitely the institution will move to the next level. To achieve these things, the alumni will be a backbone. Without alumni, we cannot ensure that this will happen. So I strongly believe that a good alumni base will be a good tool for any institution to grow. So with this word, I conclude. Thank you.
Absolutely. And Meenakshi, ma'am, closing remarks from you.
Our alumni are our brand ambassadors. They are our reputation. They are everything for us. And as an institute, not only do we give them engineering, strong base in engineering, we also teach them human values. We have humanities courses that they take. So they come out as, you know, well-rounded individuals. And I think over the years, they have realized the value of that. And so what we invest in them, we are definitely going to reap. And as everybody here, as Dr. Sumi said, as Mr. Pradeep and Mr. Vignesh, they are, you know, our investments and they are our assets. So sure. Without them, nothing is going to happen. We are very happy. We do this investment very happily. You know, I think both the parties are very engaged. This is a very happy relationship. For somebody who has just taken up office, you know, a few years ago in this, I'm thoroughly enjoying it. And I'm seeing, you know, what our faculty have invested in them and what we are getting back. So I'm very proud of both our faculty as well as our alumni. And it's the way to go.
Sure, ma'am. So I'll make a couple of announcements before we close down. And thanks to our speakers. So I'll just share my screen. So very interestingly, we have been thinking about how can we help the colleges with their alumni relations and various things. And we started a new initiative called Career Center, where we are providing basically ways to engage with alumni with an end-to-end support. Includes like how do you identify speakers, how do you use the technology. We've been at forefront of that. Even some of the sessions, we have been the moderators as well, helping the institution with that. And also the outreach across all partner institutions, because it's not only for if it's an expert from your alumni who's coming in, it's not only restricted to your college. You can actually reach out to all our colleges that we're working with. And also like, how do you generate e-certificates? And that's an initiative called Career Center that we have launched. And the way you signed up for this today's initiative is through the same platform. And second important, most important announcement today is this alumni leadership program. What we have realized is that most of the institutions want to learn about how do you really build an alumni program and how do you go ahead. And being in the space for quite some time, like almost 7 years in the first institution that we've been working with, we understand in and out of what are the important aspects and best practices that been worked on. So I thought, why not create a way where actually institutions can engage and like learn, assign people to actually learn from their alumni offices. And so this is a new 6-week training program that we're launching. It basically covers everything about building alumni communities. One is branding your alumni, how do you, various strategies that you can build a program to run, how do you run your mentor programs, how do you run your fundraising, because Indians by default is not so good at fundraising as such in West. So what goes into fundraising and various engagement strategies and best practices. So this is a program that will all of you will get a link of how do you look at enroll. It's free for all our customers who have been with WOW for, and we want like at least 2 enrollments from each of them for Nurture Plan customers, and for other customers, Grow and Basic Plan, we want to offer at least 1 enrollment free for all of them. So that we wanted to see, hey, we can actually build a community entirely and do this as an ongoing process and not just a one-time engagement like a session like this. So do nominate your people, like any alumni officers or anyone who actually can learn from this program. It will be very wonderful. Thing, and we will get guest lectures, like all the speakers again as guest lectures for these sessions. And most important part, the webinar series that we are doing, there's another important webinar that's coming up tomorrow, which is from a director of Microsoft. He's speaking about, with this entire series that we've been trying to do is about technology in real life. And what are the various technologies? So many sessions are coming up in the next week, blockchain, IoT, and experts who are working in the industry at the forefront actually are going to share. So do share this across to all your students and they will be very much beneficial. We already have about like 300 plus registrations for this session for tomorrow. He's Surendra Tipuraju. He also wrote a book for what does AI mean in called Seventh Sense AI. It's a more generic way. He's leading the AI at Microsoft in Hyderabad and AI domain at Microsoft in Hyderabad. And so I would like to thank our partners, Asma, who has been helping us with outreach, the community outreach partner. And the most important part is a VR partner, Imaginate. I'll probably show you this screen. Okay. So this, after the session, there's a virtual setup that we have created. This is like a conference that you can actually join from your desktop and move around interacting with all other speakers, as well as audience who are there. Our team will also be there in the session helping you out any questions that you have. So please download the link is being shared in the chat. I think Gagan had shared the link in the chat. You'll have to just download that and access this. Very interesting conference. You can probably look at how do you want to utilize this for your organization in terms of like maybe you're doing a virtual convocation, virtual reunion, whatever that you want. And so we thought like, let's give it a sense of what it means to, and do it, it's like a game. You actually can move around the entire playfield and start interacting. Do experience that, you'll probably, this one time, once in a lifetime experience, there's only like very less number of companies doing that. Imaginate is one of the forefront of doing that. So that's the contact details. If you need anything, cc@war.com, that's called careercenter@war.com. And Gagan, Gagan is also in the call. He has been the alumni officer at lovely professional university and working with us full time now. Just reach out to him in case we need. So that's the call. I would like to thank everyone, especially Meenakshi ma'am, Sumija ma'am, Srijit sir, and Pradeep sir. Thank you very much for taking your time out, helping us understand the best practices that you've been working at your institutions. We will connect back again. And there are a lot of questions. I'm really apologize to the audience. There are more than 30 questions which are unanswered right now. We have the questions that are recorded. We will try to connect back if there's specific things that like Meenakshi ma'am or Sumija ma'am or anyone who's working on, if you have any specific questions, we will actually try to connect back. We will try to build that gap. And that's the best way to learn is what we see. Rather than we telling and explaining things, it's the best way is like already the people who are practicing it for quite some time share these experiences. So thank you, ma'am. Everyone, thank you really for taking your time out and joining the session. So I realize that we have been bad at managing time, which we thought of making it 1.5 hours, and we are already, so maybe my bad planning, but we had so many good speakers that we want to bring in. Sure, ma'am.
Thank you, Paresh.
It was a pleasure. Thank you all the panelists.
Yeah, thank you. All the panelists. Thank you.